Hello and welcome to Evening News. I'm Amina Chiyama. In tonight's top stories, Maldives Police Service, Malé City Council and Housing Ministry have agreed to install more street lights in Malé as part of their efforts to improve public safety in the capital. Home Ministry says that a date to hold the elections of Maldives Media Council, MMC, will be announced next week. And Islamic Ministry says that visa arrangements have been made for all pilgrims going for Hajj from the Maldives this year. Police Service, Malé City Council and Housing Ministry have agreed to install more street lights in Malé as part of their efforts to improve public safety in the capital. The agreement was reached during discussions held among the three institutions regarding the installation of more street lights to improve visibility at night. Discussions were held on various logistical issues associated with such a project and ways to expedite it. The institutions also discussed what needs to be done to fix the existing lights or improve lighting at certain spots. Members of the Information Communications Technology Department of the MPS are to work with teams from the City Council and the Housing Ministry to complete this project as soon as possible. The Head of Central Operations Command, Chief Superintendent of Police, Ismail Naveen, attended the meeting as the representative of the Maldives Police Service, along with some other senior members. Home Ministry says that a date to hold the elections of Maldives Media Council, MMC, will be announced next week. According to the Ministry's Media Coordinator, Tasmeel Abdul Samad, the criminal records of all applicants have been cleared and that all administrative tasks related to the election are over. He said that the election guidelines have now been sent for publication in the Government Gazette. He said the opportunity for all media outlets to register in the election will be opened next week. 24 individuals have applied for membership at MMC, including 12 applications for the 7 posts representing the public and 12 applicants for the 8 posts representing media outlets. Islamic Ministry says that visa arrangements have been made for all pilgrims going for Hajj from the Maldives this year. According to Deputy Islamic Minister and Chairman of Hajj Corporation, Dr. Aishat Muniza, visas of all pilgrims going for Hajj with the 5 companies approved by the Ministry were arranged on Thursday. Muniza said that while officials from Saudi Arabia had visited the Maldives to put visa stamps on pilgrims' passports, the effort received great cooperation from Maldives Airports Company, MACL. Hajj pilgrims are to depart between the 8th and 16th of this month. While the 125 pilgrims going for Hajj with Accra Company will depart on 8th September, the first 250 pilgrims of Hajj Corporation will depart on 11th September. While Hajj Corporation's next 238 pilgrims will depart on the 12th, Mina Hajj Group's 125 pilgrims will leave on the 14th of this month, while the 118 pilgrims of Fatah Group will leave on the 15th, the 121 pilgrims of Sisilfar Group will leave on the 16th of this month. MTCC has agreed to provide free shuttle services between Malé and Hulule for the pilgrims. The pilgrims are to leave to Hulule from the Republic Square. We'll take a short break and return in a few minutes. said that during last week alone, 3,586 vehicles were stopped and action was taken against over 600 individuals for violating traffic regulations. According to traffic statistics issued by the police, while 18 locations were checked on duty, 3,586 vehicles were stopped and checked to see if they complied with the regulations. While 88 individuals who violated traffic regulations were advised, action was taken against 48 individuals for driving without the annual registration fee sticker or after it had expired. In addition, action was taken against 83 individuals for driving with expired roadworthiness stickers or without third-party insurance, 279 individuals for driving without a license, 202 individuals for driving with no license in hand or while their licenses were suspended, and 13 individuals for driving without renewing their licenses. In addition, 689 individuals were issued fine slips for violating traffic regulations, and 1,430 vehicles were stickered for parking against the regulations. While action was taken against 28 individuals for use on communication devices while driving, 100 individuals were taken against for not obeying traffic lights and signs. While many vehicles are being stickered for violating parking regulations, many say that they face huge constraints due to lack of parking space in Malé. Maldives Pension Administration Office is to conduct awareness programs for self-employed individuals regarding the retirement pension scheme. An official from the pension office told the TV that while the opportunity for the self-employed to register in the scheme was opened on 19th August, special awareness programs are to be conducted to familiarize them with the scheme. The pension office is to hold roadshows on select days to familiarize the self-employed with the scheme. According to the office, many self-employed individuals have already submitted their registration forms for the scheme. Speaking to the press after announcing the registration opportunity for the self-employed, CEO of Pension Office Mohammed Hussein Manik said that the government has decided to provide subsidies to encourage the self-employed to take part in the scheme. Manik said that subsidies of 2,000 rupiah will be provided on request once applicants register and start making their payments. Each year, the subsidies will be given to the first 5,000 individuals who apply for it. Police have today begun efforts to destroy vehicles impounded in their tow yard. According to Transport Authority, the vehicles were destroyed in line with the decision made by the committee concerned with destroying towed vehicles. As part of the efforts, 36 motorbikes, 4 cars and a pickup truck were destroyed at the number one waste yard in Malé. Speaking to the press after the operation, City Council's Director General Abdul Hamid Ali said that the vehicles were destroyed after completing all legal procedures and that this was the start of the efforts. He said that impounded vehicles will be destroyed as necessary each month. A large number of towed vehicles were destroyed in Tilafushi this morning as well. That concludes tonight's evening news. Thank you for joining us. Have a good night.